187.4.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Currently 3 weeks out from the Arnold Classic. As you guys just saw, I am weighing 187.4. I actually weigh 186, but since I'm holding the camera, I gain about a pound and a half. I finished up my fasted cardio this morning. I did 40 minutes fasted, low intensity. I get a lot of questions on, you know, what do I do for my cardio, and what I basically do is just try to keep my heart rate above 120 beats per minute. As far as like the machine, I'm using, you know, the elliptical. I feel like it's really easy on my joints and I'm not really taxing my entire body. It's still challenging just because, you know, I'm on low calories and I am tired. You know, just waking up, just going to do the cardio kind of sucks, but you know, you just gotta get it done. But yeah, that's what I do right now for my cardio, just low intensity, heart rate above 120 for a duration of 40 minutes. Today I plan on training some legs. I know I haven't uploaded a leg workout for this prep series yet, so I'm gonna do some legs later today. Let me show you guys how I am currently looking at 3 weeks out. Feel pretty flat and tired. Still haven't eaten my first meal yet, so I'm gonna go and cook up my first meal right now. Show you guys what I'll be eating. Starving right now. Show them the flowers. This is critical to weigh out your, you know, almond butter and peanut butter, because if you don't, I feel like a lot of people will tend to use more than what they should be, you know, using. And you know, almond butter and peanut butter is really heavy when it comes to fat, so you gotta be really careful, especially when going for a competition. So yeah, here I have 60 grams of oats, and then 16 grams of almond butter. And then I'm gonna do two scoops. Oh shit! Do two scoops of ISO HD chocolate brownie. This is like so damn good. Number two. And then also, I have some pink salt. And I'm gonna do 1/4 of a teaspoon with every meal. So right now I'm gonna be weighing out, you know, my salt with every single meal. My coach wants me to be really consistent with my salt intake and, you know, my water intake, so that way when we go to peak my body for the show, there's not gonna be any, you know, questions or anything out of the norm. I'm gonna try to keep it as consistent as possible. But yeah, this is my breakfast. I really enjoy eating this like the first thing in the morning, just cause I love chocolate and, you know, I get that craving. I like to have this as my first meal, so gonna enjoy this. Planning on training legs later today around like 6:30 p.m. So right now it's only 12. I do feel kind of tired from, you know, just the fast cardio, so I'm probably just gonna catch up with my clients and then maybe read a little bit, maybe take a little nap, and then I'm gonna be training some legs later. So yep, I'm gonna dig into these bold oats. This thing looks so freaking good. This is so good. But I just want to talk a little bit about my prep and explain to you guys, you know, how I'm feeling right now. Right now I feel great. My coach is really happy with how I'm looking, and I'm getting a lot of feedback from, like, you know, my friends and my girlfriend, and I feel like I'm in a really good spot with where I'm at from the show. There are some things I feel like I can improve on, which is, you know, my posing. I always used to just not really practice, and I feel like it hurts me when I get on stage because they do keep us up there for a while. Even if you nail your conditioning for the show, if you're not conditioned to hold the poses, then it can really throw off your physique. So I think it's really important to really practice your posing. And I'll say start that around like 5 to 6 weeks out from your competition. What I like to do is I'll set a timer for like 30 seconds where I'll hit a pose, and then once that timer goes off, then I'll wait for like maybe 20 to 30 seconds, then I'll repeat it again and making sure I'm nailing that right angle that, you know, my coach wants me to. I'll try to throw up a photo on here so you guys can see the little differences that I can make and where my physique can kind of change with just a little tweak. Yeah, the posing is really important. You can work so hard in the gym, do all the cardio, training, diet, but if you're not practicing, you know, the posing and displaying your physique, then it can really hurt you. I'm starting to pull back on the high intensity cardio just because my coach thinks that it kind of like depletes me a little too much, and I did lose a lot of weight. My last check-in, I was down to 185. In this check-in, I was, I didn't check in with my coach today, but I weighed myself this morning and I was 186. I mean, with the camera, it says 187.5, but I weigh 186 right now. So I think I'm in a good spot right now to really just maintain and just slowly just keep attacking, you know, the body fat and just slowly strip it off. And I think the low intensity cardio is working well for that. So as far as my training, I'm not really training until failure at this point in the prep, just because I feel like I don't recover as well. So for example, if I'm doing like working sets of, you know, barbell rows, I still go pretty heavy in the sense that I challenge myself for a weight that I know I can complete like 8 reps. And if I really push it, I can reach 10. So I try to get around like 6 to 10 reps for my, more from like my compound lifts. And then after that set, I would rest for up to maybe 2 minutes just so I can really recover and then exert that same exact kind of effort into the next working set. I feel like for me, that's what's been working well and I've been recovering good from it. In the past, I remember I've just been doing like a lot of volume and just trying to superset everything, drop set everything. And I just remember like not recovering that well from that kind of training. So this time around, do more of the compound lifts in the beginning, you know, 3-4 working sets, all depending on how I feel. And then towards the end, I'll do more volume and just focus on contractions. And but yeah, that's how my training is right now and it's going well. For supersets, mainly with like shoulders, I feel like I get the best workouts when I do supersets with shoulders. But for like chest, I don't really do that much supersets because I just feel like my chest doesn't really recover that well from it. So I just kind of minimize the workload for chest. But for shoulders, I can go above and beyond and do a lot of, you know, drop sets, supersets and things like that, and recover's fine.
I was there. This is so damn good.
Taking these boys on a walk before they get their bath. It's Sunday right now and I'm just trying to kill time. So, you know, I'm just gonna be washing my little puppies, you know, just cleaning up around the place. So here at the ball spa.
Out and say, I gotta get it off my chest. Got no anger, got no malice, just a little bit of regret. No, nobody else will tell you. So there's some things I gotta say. Gonna jot it down and then get it out, and then I'll be on my way. No, you're not half the man you think that you are. And you can't fill the hole inside of you with money, drugs, and cars. I'm so glad I never ever had a baby with you. Cause you can't love nothing unless there's something. I feel so sorry, I feel so sad. I tried to help you, it just ain't you mad yet. And I had no warning about who you are. I'm just glad I made it out without breaking down. And then ran so fucking far that you would never. I really meant well from the start. Take a broken man right in my hands and then put back all his parts. But you're not half the man you think that you are. And you can't feel the hole inside of you with money.
Fresh clean boys. He's like a little fluffy marshmallow. Meal number 2, I have 6 ounces of salmon, 100 grams of white rice, a handful of spinach, and then some asparagus,
I will also be adding 1/4 teaspoon of the pink salt. This is going to be my second meal of the day. Feeling pretty tired, so I'm excited to eat this meal and just get some rest. Alright guys, I'm going to make my intro workout before I head to the gym and train some legs. This is my intro stack right here. I have the best BCAA fruit punch. I do one scoop. COA plus L-carnitine. I like to drink this while I'm working out. It tastes really good. That is my intro stack right here. Alright, head to the gym, train some legs, and I'll see you guys there. We'll be right back.
back of your neck. Can you feel your heart beating right out of your chest? Are melting, I can hear the ceiling screaming, come down. I can't believe we built this room. It was meant to be a sanctuary, not a prison. There's something strange going on in this house. It's like we're pushing all these buttons, trying to start a war amongst ourselves, but we don't know what we want. All we know is that we don't want what they want. Something wrong with the castle they're in, watching over every single move that we made. Try to see past their perfect smiles. They were supposed to be protectors, not a fucking pressers. There's something wrong with the way that they speak. Like the more that they take from us, the better off we'll be. Anything to get the power they seek. All I know is that they don't want.
Workout did a lot of volume, focused a lot on hamstrings, and then for quads I did a lot of contractions, you know, leg extensions and all that. Overall it was a great workout, felt great. I finished up with 30 minutes of low intensity steady state cardio. Now I have two meals left. I'm not going to show you those meals because it's getting late. I'm depleted. I'm tired. I still got to edit the video. So my next meal is going to be 7 ounces of tilapia and then 100 grams of white rice. And then the last meal is 2 scoops of ISO-HD protein and then 16 grams of almond butter. So that's going to be my last two meals of the day. Trying my best this entire prep and, you know, being on point with my uploads and everything. And I really appreciate everybody that has been following this journey so far. And I promise that I'll, you know, do my best leading up to the show, and excited to meet everybody that heads out for the competition. If you guys are heading out to Arnold, you know, come say what's up to me. Excited to meet you guys. But yeah, that's gonna wrap up this video. Hope you guys enjoy it, and I'll see you guys in my next video.